In this video, we will see some special diodes and some special display circuit. Some special diodes like that is one is LED light emitting diode or photodiode or Schottky barrier diode and last one is varector. These are some types of diode that we are going to read in this video and some display circuit like liquid crystal display. And the second one is 7-segment display. So these are two display circuit and this is some types of diode. Okay, before going to this types of diode and display circuit, that one thing let's know, that one circuit that is called voltage doubler. What is a voltage doubler? A voltage doubler means the output that will be nothing but the two times double of the my input. So let's take, if this is my input, if this is VP, here one capacitor is there and one diode is over here. And another capacitor is there. Here it is C1, here it is C2. This is D1, this is D2. Okay, I am giving a voltage, suppose this is my input voltage, Vin, VP, which is nothing but VP. And the peak value having capital P, it is a function of time. Now see, when in forward bias, this P side is connected to, this positive half is connected to P side, negative of battery is connected to N side. And so this diode will work. And the positive half is connected to N side, and this negative half is connected to P side. So this diode will not work for first positive half. So positive half, what will happen? So my circuit will become like this. For positive half, this is my circuit, the capacitor is there. And I am taking all for the ideal cases. So this diode is working, this diode it will not work. And here one capacitor is there. Okay. Now it is VP, that is the maximum voltage, that is in terms of VP is applied over here. And since there is no, this diode is open circuit, it is in a reverse bias condition. So this part is not there, current will not flow. So the current will flow through this. And as the current flow, the circuit is closed. Then the capacitor will charge to a value VC. So what is my VC? If I write a loop for here, VC is nothing but I will get, that is the maximum voltage, which is VP. So for the forward bias, the capacitor will charge up to a maximum voltage of VP. Okay, and that is the, and this, since there are no other circuit in this circuit, there are no other any component, so the capacitor will not discharge. So the charge that is accumulated by the capacitor will stored. Now for the negative half of the cycle, for the negative half of the cycle, what, this will become negative, this will become positive. And across the capacitor, what is the charge that is present, will see nothing but VP. Now this diode will be in reverse bias because this positive side is connected to the N part and this negative side is connected to P side. So this diode will reverse bias, and as the negative side is connected to negative side of battery, N side is connected to negative side of battery, this diode will work. So as the diode will work, I am taking for ideal condition. For both cases it is ideal, and here it is ideal means it is short circuit and a capacitor present over here. And across the capacitor, I am going to take my output. I am going to take my output. And now this is VP. And across the capacitor, what is the charge flow in this positive negative? That is also VP. And that is my output, V output. Now this is a complete loop. So the current will flow. If a current will flow through this, what will be my that voltage across output? If I write a loop, which is nothing but minus VP, again minus VP, again minus V out, which is nothing but zero. So my V out I am getting, that is equal to 2 minus 2 VP. Okay. So if I take the mod of this, I will get a mod of this which is nothing but 2 VP. So I am getting a voltage which is almost equal to double of the input maximum voltage. Means if I will draw a graph between V output and T, I will get a value of 2 VP. I will get a value of 2 VP. This is nothing but my 2 VP. This is nothing but minus 2 VP. So I am getting a my voltage, which is nothing but minus 2 VP that I got over here. Okay. So using this circuit for positive of this capacitor is charging to a maximum value of VP. Okay. And for the reverse bias, this capacitor is charging. So I am taking all this charge and this voltage and this voltage, which gives me output voltage, which is nothing but 2 VP. So this is called a voltage doubler. Means I am getting double of the input voltage, maximum input voltage. Okay, that thing you should know how to make a voltage doubler. Now let's see the Schottky barrier diode. So how a Schottky barrier diode is formed? The Schottky barrier diode is formed when we make a contact between a metal and a moderately doped n-type semiconductor. When we contact a metal and a moderately doped semiconductor, then what happens? This contact, this junction will behave like a diode. So how in the diode the current flow? This is the anode. Since this is a metal, this is the anode of the metal, and this is the cathode of the metal. Now this is the anode of the semiconductor, and this side will be the cathode of semiconductor. So the current flow in the diode, that is a metal semiconductor diode, from anode of this metal to cathode of the semiconductor. Are you getting or not? This is the diode become formed because of this metal and semiconductor contact. And across the diode, the current flows from anode of the metal to the cathode of the semiconductor. Okay, so this diode behaves almost similar to my PN junction diode. But there are two changes. In semiconductor diode, that normal PN junction diode, my current because of majority charges also and because of minority charges also. Okay, but here in Schottky barrier diode, my current, which is only because of the majority charge carrier. That is only because of majority charge carrier. Since there are no minority charge carrier present, so I can easily on and off my Schottky barrier diode as compared to PN junction diode. PN junction diode can be easily on and off as because of this minority charge carrier. So since this Schottky barrier diode is independent of this minority charge carrier, only the current flow in through this diode is because of majority electron or majority holes. So I can easily on and off. And the second point, that is for Schottky barrier diode, is nothing but it need a very less amount of voltage to start. Means for PN junction diode, I need a 0.6 to 0.8 for practical cases. I need this much voltage to start. That is the VT I call threshold voltage. But in this case, it need 0.3 to 0.5. This much voltage is sufficient to on this Schottky barrier diode. So that is one advantage. And the second advantage is we can easily on and off this Schottky barrier diode. Okay, these are some short question it might arise in your exam, some 2 mark hardly. So this much point is enough. And the second one is varector. What is a varector? The varector name came from, it is a variable voltage capacitor. Or I can say by changing the capacitor, my voltage is varying. If you remember in the PN junction diode in reverse bias case, my VCJ junction capacitor or depletion the capacitor is nothing but proportional to VR. My CJ is proportional to VR. If you remember, I wrote CJ equal to VR upon 1 plus something upon whole power n. So my CJ, which is proportional to VR. So as I am changing my voltage, decreasing or increasing, my charge storage capacity is changing. So this property of this diode, it can act as a diode in which my voltage is changed, my capacitor is changed by changing the voltage. That's why the name varector. Varector diode is called variable voltage capacitor. Okay. The third one is LED. I said there are 4 types of diode that are going to read in this special diode. One is Schottky barrier, one is varector, third one is LED, last one is photodiode. This LED and this photodiode both are inversely proportional to each other. Means the function of LED is totally different or inverse of this photodiode. So let's see what is LED and photodiode. Full form is light emitting diode. It means it will emit the light. So what is the symbol for this LED? If this is a diode, here these are the lights that are emitting. Okay. These are the diodes that are lights that are emitting because of this. I am giving supply over here. So you see how this is my PN junction diode. This is my PN junction. This is P type, this is N type. In this PN junction, this is P side, means it is full of holes. And it is full fill of electron, means these are the major charge carrier. Okay. In forward bias, if I will apply this forward bias, then what happens? These holes will move to this region and electrons will move to this region. Okay. And then there is a combination. So how these electron holes are moved? It is because of the energy level. Suppose this is one valence band, this is one conduction band. When an electron either moving to here, occupying a hole over here, or an electron coming from here to here, it needs some energy. That is called band gap energy. And this energy is nothing but E equal to H nu or HF, that is in terms of frequency. So in frequency I can write H equal to C by lambda. So my energy, which is inversely proportional to the wavelength. Okay. So if a electron, it will move from valence band to conduction band, or then only it can conduct current, or a electron from here to here, then it needs some energy. That energy is proportional to the wavelength. As you know, there are various types of visible lights. Visible light means these are the light which we can see from in our naked eye, right? Red, blue, green. So each having some wavelength. Suppose this is a wavelength having 680 to 720. Suppose some different color having some different wavelength. So based upon the wavelength, that light needs that much energy. If I will provide that much energy, then this particular electron for the red light, it can easily move to other region, other band. And if it will move, then they will conduct current. And because of that, as they are moving, they are emitting the light, that is in terms of energy, that is called photon. That we are seeing in an LED. Okay. So in an LED, if I am supplying or applying some voltage over here, and because of this carrier transfer from electron to hole or hole to electron, they are recombining. As they are recombining, so this recombining means that is because of this energy that needed to a electron move from here to here or a electron from here to here. So that depend upon the wavelength. So based upon our color, so wavelength is defined already. So based upon the color, if I need a red light, my LED should grow red. Then according to the wavelength, that much energy, 1 by wavelength, that much energy should be given so that the electron can move from here to here. Then they will conduct current and they will emit energy in terms of photon, light in terms of photon. That is called red, that is called my LED. Okay. This is applied for forward bias. This LED, this will emit only light in forward bias. But normally diode, they will not emit light. But this LED will emit light when this forward bias condition, when this all this happen. But in reverse bias condition, my LED behaves like a normal diode. My LED behaves like a normal diode in reverse bias condition. Remember this. This LED works in forward bias, then only it can emit light. But in reverse bias, it will behave like a normal diode. So in forward bias, what happens? The minority charge carrier that are transferring electron hole from here and here, that is because of minority charge carrier. You remember I told a diagram over here in some previous video that we are injecting some holes and electron from this side or holes from this side. So these minority charge carrier give rise me a this minority charge carrier that transferred, and because of that energy is generating. Okay, but how this LED is formed? This LED is formed by the combination, as I told, this is because of this formed by a direct band gap material. So there are two types of material. One is direct band gap and second one is indirect band gap. So this LED is formed by direct band gap energy. The one example of this direct band gap material is nothing but gallium arsenide. So it is a compound material. In our starting video, I said there are two types of semiconductor. One is single, that is only silicon or germanium. Or there are some compound material like gallium arsenide, indium phosphide. So these are the compound material. So here the gallium arsenide, which is a direct band gap material, which can be used to make this LED. Okay. So this is the concept when the minority, because of forward bias, minority holes are, that is injected. So they cross the barrier and recombine. And because of that, there's some energy that is, this recombination takes place because of this energy. And that depends upon the wavelength, which gives me a light. Okay. So this is the LED. And now the photodiode, which is the inverse function of this LED. What is a photodiode? In LED, LED is giving me our light. We are supplying current, or that is in terms of voltage, we are supplying current that we are getting light. But here photodiode, what will happen? Here light will fall over here at this photodiode, it will give me current. How? If the light will fall on this semiconductor junction or semiconductor diode, then what happens? There are electron and hole pair. As this light will fall over here, they are the covalent bond. Between this true semiconductor, one is silicon, suppose one is silicon over here. So there is a covalent bond. As the light falls, this covalent bond will break. So as this covalent bond will break, so I will get electron and hole, which was pairing before, but now it will become electron hole pair. So as this electron hole pair move across the junction of this PN junction, then they will give me a current. So as light fall, there is a break of the semiconductor. So because of that, electron hole pair generated. As the electron hole pair generated and the cross, because of the electric field applied here or voltage, because of voltage, so they give rise to my current. And that current that I am getting at the output of a photodiode. Okay, in LED I was supplying current, and what I was getting light. But in photodiode, here I am supplying light. This light might be from any source, either maybe from sunlight or that light I am providing from myself. So that photodiode will give me current. Okay. So these are the four type of special diode that we read, and one is Jenner diode that we already read before. Now let's see two type of display circuit. One is liquid crystal display and second one is 7-segment display. So a 7-segment display, what is the function of a display? It display was the number. In a 7-segment display, what it display? Display was a number that might be a whole number or a decimal. Suppose I want to write my 7 or I want to write my 3.5. So this 3.5 and 7 I can display in my 7-segment display. Why the name 7-segment display? Let's see. Okay, these pins are A, B, C, D, this is E, this is F, it is G, it is H. Why I am writing in this odd and a method? That is, a 7-segment display is measured. When you will measure this 7-segment display, you will see this terminal, if you will connect a battery, that means I am supplying a battery over here, and along with the battery I am going to connect a resistor, just so that this 7-segment display, how it is made? It is made from LEDs. Okay, there are some 7 LEDs over there. So this 7 LED, or this here is one, that one 8 LEDs are there. So these LEDs should not burn, so that I should connect a battery with a resistor, so that this resistor will oppose the flow of current. So how I am knowing this is A or this is B? If you flip this 7-segment display, if you flip, then from the back one, there are 10 pins. So I am going to connect. Suppose this is the positive terminal, this is the negative terminal. Okay, one more thing. These are the some 8, 2, 2, 2, 6, 8 pins. This is A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And this pin is H, which is nothing but for this pin. For this dot, for the decimal point, this H is there. And these two, this and this, they are internally short, internally connected. And they are called common points. Okay, don't worry, I am telling how to make this common point and what are that. So what is the common point? If this is my LED, suppose this is a LED, light emitting diode, it is a diode, and for this diode, this is the anode and this is the cathode. As I said, there are 8 LEDs over here. Suppose this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and like there are 8 LEDs. If I will make this all the anodes of each LEDs to a single common point, then this common point and this common point will be called anode, common anode. Common anode means all the 8 LEDs whose anodes are connected at this point. These two terminals are internally connected. These two, it means it is a one line, it is connected internally. If this is the front view that you are seeing, there are 8 pins. If you flip this, here it is one middle point, that is common point, here is one middle. So these two are connected internally. So this common line, it might be an anode, common anode. And if I will connect the cathodes of each diode, then it is called a common cathode. Okay, if I will connect all the cathodes of diodes of the all 8 LEDs in its path and connected to this common point, if I connect this, then it will call common cathode. Okay, now how this A, B, C, D I am going to measure? That, let's see. Okay, as I said, I have a battery. Suppose you have a battery. And this battery, this is the positive terminal, this is the negative terminal. These two are internally connected. It means it is a single point. It is one connection is there. Okay, suppose I am going to connect my positive half of battery to this terminal. Positive half of the terminal, this is nothing but my anode. And this is my cathode. This is the positive half is connected over here. And I am going to negative terminal with a resistor so that my circuit should not burn. And I will measure with this A point. Okay. I don't know this is A or B. I don't know. But I know this is my A, B, C, D. They are written like this. So if I am going to take my negative terminal of battery with a resistor, that will oppose the high flow. And I will measure this terminal. If I will measure at this time, if my this part, this segment is glowing, this segment is glowing means I will name it as A. Okay, so various types of 7 second display are there, according to their names are different. So if I will connect a battery, this is the glowing means this is A. And now I am going to measure this point. If I am connected this common terminal to the positive half and negative half through a resistor, through this G point. If my this part is only growing, only this part is going, it means this is my G part. That's why accordingly that I have written. Okay. Now, whether you tell me whether this is a common anode or common cathode. When this G part is glowing means this connection is perfect. It means my anode is connected over here. It means it is a common anode 7 segment display. It is glowing means it is working properly. It is a common anode 7 segment display. If after connecting over here, neither any segment is glowing, nor this 7 segment, neither this 7 segment, nor this dot, nothing is glowing. It means my connection is a bit wrong. So for that, what I have to do? I have to remove from here. One, I have to remove from here. I have to connect the negative part to the common and to the positive part over here. It means it is a common cathode. It is a common cathode 7 segment display. Are you getting or not? So by measuring each terminal, each pins, I came to know that this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, E, F, like this. Okay. So it varies. It is not fixed, it varies. Now, and these two common points are internally connected. They are made short. Don't connect the battery one terminal over here, one terminal over. If it will make like this, it will become short and it will burn out. Okay. So if I want to write, suppose I want to write one, then how I'll write one? For that, I have to glow my pin B and pin C. If I connect this pin B and pin C, it will give me a value 1. If I want to write 2, then I have to glow A, V, G, E, D. This is A, this is B and C. This is A, V, G, E and D. Okay. If I want to write 8, then all 7 segments should be glow. Then only I can write 8. Anything you can write. Either you want to write 5, 9. For 9 means this top 4 and this 2. Sorry, only this top 4 and this one. That is 9. Now I want to write 3.5. Then how I can write 3.5? For the first part, I have to write 3. So this is 3. My A, B, G, C and D. This is 3. For 5, I can write like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. That is A, F, G, C, D. But how to put this dot? For that, this dot is given. So if I will connect my battery to this S terminal, that means this dot will glow. And from this I can easily write to 3.5. Okay. So this is the 7 segment display which having 7 segment and for displaying any number that you can write. So I want to write suppose 7532. So I have to connect 4 7 segment display in a series so that I can make it a number like this. Okay. Now, the second display which is nothing but liquid crystal display. Let's see that one also. So, liquid crystal display, this name LCD means liquid crystal display. You have seen that before some 5 to 10 years, there are only TV which the shape and size was very big, weight was very heavy. And nowadays the TVs which are coming in our home that we are seeing, which having a very big, that is called flat display, and the thickness is very thin. So that's why this LCD become very popular because of its very wide screen or the thickness is very small. So how this LCD works? In before that 10 years, that TV is the big size TV, how they were working? They were working because of that electron is gone that is applied to this. It means we can say that CRT, that is cathode ray tube. Using this cathode ray tube, those TVs were working. So how this CRT work? We have to shoot 3 gun, electronic gun. Through electronic gun, I have to shoot them. Then from this electron, the picture that are getting. But nowadays is LCD, which became very popular in nowadays, whose weight is very less and the screen is very flat. Okay, so how it is working? it will see this TV. If you see this TV from a distance, you will not get what is happening inside there. But once you come to the, once you come close to this TV, you will see there are number of millions of pixels that is present in the screen. Once you come close to the, very close to this LCD TV, LCD screen, you will see there are millions of pixels that is present. So how these pixels are forming? So the background story, the background, what is happening inside the LCD, that is seems like this. Let me draw that one first. Okay, so this pixel, these are the million of pixels as I told. This pixel, once they will grow into red, green or blue, then only you can see the picture on the screen. Okay, so how the pixels will on and off? So this liquid crystal display, it works based on the liquid crystal. Means it is a display which works with liquid crystal. So what is a liquid crystal? It is a crystal. What is a crystal? In a crystal, as I have told in before, that the atoms are arranged in a crystalline manner or they are in a fixed position. So in liquid crystal, it is neither a liquid nor a solid, but its property in between the liquid and solid. So normally, if I say in liquid crystal, how the atoms are there? If I take an example of matchbox, let's take an example of a matchbox. So in a matchbox, if you remember, there are, these are the matchsticks which are present inside the matchbox. So if you will close the cover of this matchbox, if you will shake, so you can easily shake this movement from here to here, but you can't change the movement of this head to this tail or to this head to this tail, but you can move only from through and through or from top and down. So the, these two can easily rotate one over another, but they can't change their motion. So this is the case which happened inside liquid crystal. So liquid crystal, the atoms are arranged like the arrangement of a sticks in a matchbox. So how, what happened over here? How these pixels will grow? You see, suppose this is the screen that we are seeing over here. Okay, and this is the backside of this display which coming with, which has a very high intensity of light, having some verticals and some horizontal lights are there. There are lots of various of lights that are coming from here over here, and brightness is very high. So what happened in this liquid crystal display? There are two polarized filter. These two are called polarized filter. Okay, what is the function of that? This is one polarized filter which is called horizontal polarization. You can see the lines which are shown over here. These are horizontal. This is nothing but horizontal polarization filter. And this is nothing but my vertical polarization filter. You will see the lines that are present which are having vertical lines. So what is the work of these two polarization filters? They will obstruct. This is nothing but a filter. So what is the function of a filter? It will obstruct the signal. So in how they are obstructing the signal, let's see. Okay. Now a high intensity of light coming over here. So as the high intensity of light which contain both horizontal and vertical some light segment, this horizontal filter will only allow only the vertical vibration signal. Those are having only vertical vibration. Okay, the vertical, it will allow only vertical, sorry, these are the horizontal vibration. These are vibrating in horizontally. That's why this horizontal polarization filter, it will allow those. Now here it is nothing but the transistor. This is nothing but the transistor. So inside this transistor, this liquid crystal that are present over here, inside the transistor, the liquid crystal are present. So when this horizontal vibration movement of light which come to this transistor, what happen at this time when my pixels are off? It means the screen is off. What happen? This transistor, inside the transistor, the current will flow and they will oppose the movement of this horizontal. Means the transistor, inside the transistor, the, because of this presence of atom, the current flow through this. So they will not allow, they will not change the direction of this horizontal movement. So what will be the output? The output will be the same horizontal. Whatever the input is there, that will come over here. Because at this time, when the pixels is, when I'm not getting any screen, then what happened? This transistor flow, inside the transistor, current is flowing. So they are not changing any property of this horizontally vibration. So the output, what I'm getting? The same horizontal vibration movement are there. It is the same which is present over here. And the next filter, polarization filter, which is nothing but vertical polarization. So since this is horizontal movement, these are vibrating horizontally, so it will not allow. So after whatever will be the output, output will be zero. Means this horizontal movement is not fit for this polarization, this filter, because this filter only take vertical movement. So the output I am getting a blank, or my pixels are off. Okay, this is the first condition. What happens when my pixels are glowing? Means I am getting the screen. What happens? At that time, these three processes are same. Here, a high intensity of light of various lights are coming through this horizontal vibration movement. This polarization filter, it will filter the only horizontal and obstruct all other values. Okay. Now, it is filter is these pixels are working, means this transistor, inside this transistor, the current, that is electricity, that force to stop. If this force to stop, this horizontal movement come over to this transistor, they will bend. This transistor, these are the crystal, liquid crystal present over, so they will bend. As they will bend and this horizontal movement pass through this, they will change my orientation of the light signal that is coming. That it will become vertical. That is the property of this liquid crystal, that we are not interested now to know what is the property of liquid crystal. But as this current, these pixels are on, means this inside the transistor current is totally off. And the, since this current is off, they are what, because of this horizontal movement, they are bending the crystal present over here. As they are bending, because of this bend inside the crystal, this horizontal movement now twisted by 90 degree. Twisted by 90 degree to become vertical movement, vertical vibration. Now you can see these are the vertical vibration. Now the stage come over here, which is nothing but my vertical polarization filter. As this vertical movement coming over here, this vertical polarization, it will now allow this signal. It will now allow the vertical movement. And that vertical movement coming into the screen that I am seeing in terms of red, green and blue. These are the three colors of light that we are seeing in over here. Once you go close to your TV and see the number of pixels, every small pixel. And for the each pixel, this is the process how light comes. And if you combine all the pixels, we are going to get a picture or a video that is seeing in our TV. Okay. So this is all about the display. So till this point, we have completed the third chapter of our first module, that is the semiconductor diode. That is the first module is over. In the next video, I will try to cover all the three chapters of a first module in a single video, so that it's just like a revision. So in that video, what I will do, we'll see the notes that I have made for you. So as you can see in the last of each video, I already provided notes. So from these notes, I'm going to make you just a one type of revision. And after that, we'll start our next module. That is either second module or third module, according to our convenience. Okay.